Now that the fabric is through the printer and everything is ready to load on the take-up roll, there's a couple things to consider. We put the core on. The core is a little bit longer than the fabric, so everything is ready there. Now, when you load fabric, sometimes what you'll find is that it loads too much, and then you can't feed it backward. You have a couple options there. Option one is you cut it. If you do cut it, I recommend having a really good pair of fabric shears that you only use for fabric. They're helpful. They're going to cut through the fabric cleanly and they're not going to fray. If you use just any old scissors, a lot of times they're going to mangle the fabric pretty badly. So buy a good pair of fabric scissors and use those exclusively for the fabric. That's my recommendation. You can cut it, and cutting it's going to have some waste. The machine's not going to let you roll any backward. Sorry, it just happens that way. However, what I'll do sometimes is I'll lift the lever and I'll kind of slide it back and pull it and slide it back and pull it, and basically I'll rewind it on the roll kind of manually. In this case, I just cut it. I'm a little pressed for time, so I just trimmed off the edge. It was maybe a foot. Once that's done, I'm going to put the tape on it. I like three pieces of tape. I want it very secure on that core. Now, if you put the tape on the fabric just as is, what's going to tend to happen is the tape's going to come right off that fabric. So it's going to tape to the core, and that's going to stick. But the tape on the fabric isn't going to stick. And that's going to distort you having it on the take-up roll evenly, which is very important. So what I recommend is just take a household stapler, go to the edge here, slide it into there, and go chunk. So now you're putting staples on the tape to the fabric. That's going to hold this tape on the fabric, and it's going to allow you to put some tension on it, and it won't pull off the fabric. This is sort of an old trick. So you're going to put some staples. I usually put two on each of the pieces of tape. And we'll do the last one down here. Very easy. Okay, now that's all ready to go onto the take-up roll. I habitually cut like a tiny little curve into most things because I'm going to load the middle first. That's going to be a little longer. And then I'm going to load the edges. Now, when I load them onto the core, first I put the middle on and get that nice and right. And then I take the ones in the edges and ever so gently, I pull it out a little bit. So what I'm doing is the center and then pulling them out. Not much. You're just putting a tiny little bit of pull off to the right on that side and off to the left on this so that it kind of gives it a nice even tension all the way through. Once that's done, we'll put it on here in a second, then I roll it forward, insert the dancer bar, and then initiate the take-up reel. I want to tell it that the take-up reel is on because that way it's going to re-engage the OMOS to measure the step alignment and recalculate the step alignment with the material having some tension applied. And at that point, you stand back and look at everything, and if everything's right, you are good to go. You'll find that when everything's on the take-up roll and it's nice and even and your take-up roll is a little longer, no end caps, fabric will print beautiful on a latex printer.